Hi everyone, in this video I'll be showing you how to post data in PostgreSQL database by using Node.js and Postman. So I'll be showing you first how to connect Node.js and PostgreSQL. Later I'll be showing you how to post data using Postman. So let's get started. So the prerequisite for this video is going to be you must have Node.js installed in your system, and also you must have PostgreSQL along with pg4admin. So if you don't have PostgreSQL installed, you can just click on the card that is appearing on top. I've installed it completely. So now let's get started with the code. So here I am in my Visual Studio Code. I've just opened a folder. So let me just go and create a file. Let me name it as main.js. So for this purpose, we'll be requiring only one NPM package, which is called as PG. So if I go to their official site, it's called as Node Postgres. And the command is going to be npm ipg. So it has these many weekly downloads. So let me just copy this and we're just going to run this command. So now let's begin with the code. It's going to be const within curly bracket. We need to import the client from the pg package. So it's going to be client equal to require, and within single quote, it's going to be PG, all right? And the next line, we'll be defining our host name, username, port, password, and the database name, all right? So it's going to be const, let me name it as connection something equal to, it's going to be new client. So we're going to create a object of this particular variable that we have imported. It's going to be open circular bracket, open a curly bracket. And as I told you here, first thing is going to be the host name. It's going to be the host, and within double quotes, since we are using it in our local system, it's going to be localhost, and just put a comma. Next one is going to be the username. So by default, the username of a PostgreSQL setup is going to be postgres. So this is going to be the default username, and next is going to be the port number. So it's going to be port, and the default port is going to be 5432. So in case if you are confused about this username and port number, let me show you a simple way how you can find this. You can just go to your PG admin and you'll be having the PostgreSQL 16, this particular option below servers. You're just going to right click over here and you need to go to properties, and here you'll be having option called as connection. And here you can see the host name is localhost, the port number is 5432, and the username is Postgres. So these are just the default settings. I didn't change any of this. So we are good to go now. Next thing is going to be the password. So this is going to be the password that you had given when setting up your PostgreSQL. So I will just enter my password. After entering the password, it's going to be our database name. So for that, it's going to be database. And let's just go and create a database from scratch. Just go to your PG admin and you'll be having this PostgreSQL. Expand this. By default, we'll be having, I guess, one database. I have created the other two. So you need to just right click on the database, create database. So here you need to name. So I'll just go with demo post something. And the rest are fine. You can just leave it since this is just a demo activity. Just save. That's it, you'll be getting your demo database. Later I will also show you how you can create a table as well as insert values, because we are going to write a query and get the values also. So that's like a confirmation that we have successfully connected, all right? So the name of our DB is now demo post. So I'm going here, it's going to be demo post. That's it. And final thing is we'll be using this connection variable. So I will just put that variable over here, dot connect, all right? So this basically connects with PostgreSQL, and we can just have a then, like we can just have a console, maybe like this console dot log connected. That's it, all right? So if we have successfully connected, we will be getting this. You can just have a error handling and stuff, but just a basic stuff. So I'll just have a console. So now for running this, it's going to be node and the file name .js. So make sure that you are in the right folder in the terminal. It's going to be node. space main dot js and hit enter. And here you can see we have got the console as connected. So now we are done with the first part of connecting our Node.js code with our PostgreSQL database. Let's see how we can implement the post function. So for this, we'll be requiring the express npm package. So for installing that, just open a new terminal and the command is going to be npm space I express. That's it. And yeah, it is done. So let's just import it. It's going to be const express equal to require express. That's it. And we need to define our app, const app equal to express. So using this variable only we will be creating the post function. Next is going to be app.use express.json express.json. And super important thing, you need to have here a circular bracket. Don't forget this. This means that we're just going to use JSON data. We're going to send JSON data from Postman. So that's the purpose there. So now we are ready with the setup, the basic setup of Express. So we are also having our connection ready. Next thing is we will be requiring a table, because in the table only we will be posting the data. We are having a database named as demo post. So now let's just go and create a table inside this database. So just go to your PostgreSQL and we'll be having the database over here. Expand this, and in this under schemas we'll be having public. Expand this, and here you can see we'll be having tables. So now I'm not having any tables because we haven't created any. So to create a table, just right click, create table. You can have a table name. Let me go with demo table and go to columns. Just click on this plus. We need to enter the column name, and the data type is going to be character varying. This one, don't choose the other. And this is fine, you can play around with this. And next, ID. So this is going to be of type integer, this one. So let me go with the default one. So I'll just save it. So we'll be having the demo table over here. Expand this, columns. We're having two things. So to view the data, right click and view already data, all rows. So we'll be getting the SQL query also, but currently there is nothing inside the table because this is the moment that we have created it. So this is fine. So now let's just go and create our post function. Just come outside of this connection. So it's going to be app, which is this variable dot post, and here we will be specifying our path. So within single quotes, it's going to be slash post, or you can have post data, something like this, and put a comma. It's going to be request, comma, response, and we'll be having here a arrow function like this. So let me just expand this. So first thing is we'll be getting the name and ID. That is the thing we are going to be sending from our Postman body. So here we'll be sending a JSON, and that will be created by our request.body, okay, this variable. So it's going to be const within curly bracket name and ID. So we need to send this parameters from Postman equal to request.body. Yeah. And next is going to be our insert query. So it's going to be const insert query. So this is going to be a simplest of SQL queries. Insert into table name. In our case, the table name is demo table. So just copy this. And next thing, space our column names. So it's going to be name, comma, ID. That's it. Space values. And inside the values, again open circular bracket. It's going to be $1, $2. So name corresponds to $1 and ID corresponds to $2. So this is basically the query inserted into table name. You need to have something like this. And in normal SQL query, we will be having here values. So we're just having a placeholder for that. That's the only difference over here. So we are storing this in a variable. That's it over here. And next line is going to be, we're going to execute the query. So for that, we'll be requiring our connection variable. So it's going to be CON, this variable that we have, okay? Dot, we'll be having the query function. And here we need to pass a few parameters. First one is going to be the query variable, this one. So insert query and comma, within square brackets, it's going to be name and ID. And be careful over here, the order needs to be same. Because here we are having name and ID, so you must also pass name and ID over here. Otherwise, the data types will get mismatched because this is of type string, this is of type integer. That's good. Next, we'll be having a callback function, which is going to be error, comma, result. So you can name this anything. And error function, go this way. So we'll be having a if condition just to catch the error. If there is any errors, you can just have response.send the error. You can even have a console.error also. In case if you want, you can send status response.status 500 error something, totally up to you. We're having a else block. Else we can just send response.send. You can just have posted data. And if you want, you can even like send the result, or let me just console.log the result. That's it. So this is basically our post. So simple, we're having a path. We are getting the name and ID from postman.json, catching that, writing a query, then mapping the query as well as the data. Then we are just, you know, checking if there is any errors, else we are just sending a response as data. Simple. So final thing is, the most important thing, we must start our Node.js server, right? So for that, we need to have a listen. So just minimize this post operation. You need to be outside this, okay? It's going to be app dot listen. Here we need to specify the port number. It can be anything. Let me go with the standard 3000 and another callback function. It's going to be console dot log. Server is running. Simple console. That's it. Now we are good. So let's go to terminal. Just stop it. Control C to stop. And it's going to be node main.js. So here you can see we are getting server is running, which means that our server has started. We don't have any errors like in the connection in this code. And next is connected. So now we are good. So next thing is, we need to go to Postman. So in the Postman, basically you need to go here, new tab. So you'll be getting a get by default. Most important thing changes to post, because we're performing post operation and you need to have the path. So it's going to be this one, http://localhost:3000. And this 3000 should match with this port number over here. And don't put HTTPS, it won't work. And let's just add this path. Our post path is /post data. So come here, it's going to be post data and go to body. You'll be having none. Change this to raw and select JSON. If you select text or any other thing, you'll be getting an error. So we need to send JSON. It's going to be name. Let me go with John some name, and it's going to be ID. Go with 200. So these parameters should match with this one here. So make sure that you're sending the correct thing there. And yeah, that's pretty much it. So if I now go and send from Postman, we'll be getting post data and we need to get the result in the console. So I'll just send it. So I'm getting posted data. And this is basically the result. We were having like the row count, how many rows have changed, the command. So this is fine. You don't need to like print the result. Just for demo, I did that. So now if I go to my PostgreSQL table and if I just rerun this query, so you will be having the run button. Click this. Here you can see I'm having John 200. So if I go with some other ID and some random name. We run again. So we'll be getting this. So the post operation is perfect, and I hope you'd have found this video useful. Do check the playlist of my channel. Done a lot of videos in CRUD operations like Node.js, MongoDB, MySQL, Spring Boot, many things, and OpenAI, as well as Gemini AI API tutorials, AI tools also. So check the playlist, subscribe me. Thanks for watching.